Hi friends! In today's tutorial, I'll show you a way to create a multi-style, multi-theme component using variables. At the end of this tutorial, you'll have a button component like this. It will have a primary variant and a secondary variant, but then it will also have a couple of variable modes. So the first one is going to be a theme. It could be either light or dark. And we'll also be making two styles. So here I have style 1 and here will be style 2. To get started, I did do a couple of setup things. So the first is I have a collection with just scale colors, which I got from the Chapter UI theme. And then I did create a couple buttons here, which are not components. They're just plain frames to visualize all the styles and all the themes that I want. The first thing we're going to do is we'll go back to our local variables and we're going to create a new collection, which we'll call theme. And now we're going to create our two modes. So for the theme, we're going to have a light theme. And then our second mode is going to be dark. And now we'll be adding semantic variables that map to the light and the dark themes of our button. So the first color variable is going to be a background for the primary button of this first style. So actually, the first thing I'm going to do is I'll create a group. It's going to be style 1. And then we'll write primary background. Now you can see I have a group here that's called style 1 and will be for the styles for this button set here. And now we're going to assign this primary background variable colors using the colors from our scale collection. So I'm going to go to libraries and then our first primary background. This one is just the darkest gray color. So I'll give it that. And then for our dark, it's going to be the lightest scale color. Now I'm going to do the same thing, but for text. And here it's going to be the other way around. So our text color for the light theme is going to be gray 50. And then our text color for the dark theme is going to be gray 90. The next thing we're going to do is give a color for the secondary background, which is going to be gray 50 and gray 90 for the dark theme. We'll also give text color, which will be the opposite. And then the last thing that's missing here for the secondary variant is we will want to have a border. So let's create a color variable for secondary border. And it's going to be gray 200 for our light mode. And then for dark mode, it's going to be gray 600. Now we have all of our color variables for the style 1. And we're going to return to all variables inside the theme collection. And we're going to do the same thing for style 2. So I'll create a color variable. And first I'll make a group. We'll do primary background. And this one's going to be green 600 for the light mode. And then for the dark mode, it's going to be green 100. Then we're going to do the primary text. For the light theme, it's going to be green 50. And for the dark theme, it's going to be green 900. Then we'll do secondary background. And it's just going to be gray 50 for the light theme. And gray 900 for the dark theme. Then we'll do secondary text, which is going to be green 900 for the light theme and green 50 for the dark theme. And the last thing that we need to do is secondary border, which is going to be green 300 for the light theme and green 500 for the dark theme. Now that we have all of our color variables for the light and dark theme, we'll create our third and last collection, which is called style. And in this collection for the modes, the first one is going to be for style 1, and the second one is going to be for style 2. And then we'll have just one group because we're only doing the button component, and we'll start with color variables, which will be the same that we did for our theme collection. Let's do button. And then slash to create a group. And the first one is going to be primary background. And so for this one, what I'm going to do is instead of applying the scale values, I'll be applying the values from the theme collection. This first one is style one, so it's going to be this one. And then for our second one, it's going to be style two. So it's going to be coming from the style two group. Let's click on that. And now we'll do primary text. So style one and style two. Now we'll do secondary background. Style one. Style two. We'll do secondary text. And last one is going to be secondary border. Now what we can do is we actually haven't created our button component yet. We just have this frame visuals here. So what I'm going to do is let's put this aside and we're just going to create our button component. I have a text layer here and I'm going to do Shift plus A to wrap it inside outer layout. And what I'm going to do is first we'll make our primary variant. I'm going to go into fill and I'll be choosing variables from our button group. This one will have primary background. And then for text, it's going to be primary text. We can also rename this, just call it button, turn it into a component. And from here, we're going to add a variant. And this one is going to be our secondary variant. It's going to have secondary background and it's going to have secondary text. And we would also need to add a stroke or a border. And the color of it is going to be secondary border. The last thing, we'll rename this property one to, let's just say variant. And we'll have a primary and secondary. So this one becomes our primary. This one becomes our secondary. And now let's just try to test it to see if our style switching and our theme switching works. So let's first give it a style one, which it has by default, and then theme two, which is light. And now if we switch it to style two, we can see that the colors change. We can also switch it to dark. Again, the colors change. And now we'll just double check that the dark theme also works for style one. Let's put it back to the light theme. We're almost done, but as you can see, there are a couple more things that are going on with the buttons here. The first is that they have two different border radii, and then they also have slightly different padding. The second style button has 24 horizontal and 16 vertical, but then this first one is a little bit smaller. It has 16 horizontal and 12 vertical. And these values we can just add to our style collection, to our button group. And these are going to be number variables. So the first one, let's do border radius. And our first one has 4. And our second one, I just made it 100. Then our second number variable is going to be padding X, horizontal padding. And our first one has 16 and our second one has 24. And then we'll also have padding Y, the vertical padding. This should be 16. First one is 12 and the second one is 16. One thing we can add to these variables is scoping. So we don't want the border radii variable to be visible for any other properties other than border radii. So we're going to click in this edit icon here. And for the number scoping, you can just unselect all of them and you'll just select the corner radius. And then for the padding X, we'll just do the gap. And the same is for padding Y. We could also do the same thing for all of our color ones. So for the fill, we don't want the text. And then for this one, we just want the text. And then for our last one, we just want the stroke. Okay, so now we're going to return to our component and apply all of our number variables. First, we're going to go to the corner radius and we'll apply the only value that we have here. Because this is style one, it's going to have the value of 4. Then we're going to apply the horizontal padding and the vertical padding for the overall component set. We can also add auto layout just so that when we switch different themes and styles, the overall frame adapts to the button sizes. And now that we've added our variables, we can test our styles and our modes. So that's about it. This is how you can make a multi-style, multi-theme component. A couple things I wanted to mention is that something that we could have done, for instance, is just created one collection and then did style one light, style one dark, then style 2 light and style 2 dark. This is definitely a less of a brain twisting way to do it. But a couple things to keep in mind is that you would have to repeat all of your number variables, which isn't really a big deal for just 4 modes. But if we don't have to repeat something, I think it's better not to do it. And then also, if you are on the Figma Pro plan, you can't do any more than 4 variable modes. So if, let's say, you wanted to add like a style 3 or add like a high contrast theme in addition to light and dark, you can do it. But if you break up your variables into separate collections, this is how you are able to squeeze in more themes or styles if you need it. Another thing I wanted to mention is that we do end up having a bunch of variables here, which definitely could be confusing to somebody who is using the library. Something that we can do is hide certain variables from being published. So if, let's say, we want people to stick to semantic variables and not use scale values, we can select all of this, edit, and then we'll just do hide from publishing. We can also, just to be safe, remove all the color scoping. Now, when I return to this layer, I don't see any of the green values. And then, of course, you can do that for any other variable set. So that's about everything that I wanted to cover for this tutorial. Please let me know if you have any questions, and I'll link this tutorial file in the description below. Thank you for watching, and until next time, bye-bye.